A mad scientist has captured your friend and implanted some kind of brain control device. She enters commands into a machine and your friend has no choice but to follow them. Most of us would say that he doesn't have free will, as someone else is now controlling all his actions. But what if the scientist got a bit lazy and decided to put the machine on autopilot and have a set of roulette wheels decide his behavior? With this addition of randomness, does he now have free will? Most of us would still say no. Author Sam Harris, in his book, The Moral Landscape, argues that this is the state we're all in now, and that instead of roulette wheels, our actions are decided by the unpredictable desires of our unconscious brains. But physics has a different argument against free will, and it's the idea of determinism. That events in the future are caused by events in the past. If we follow that logic all the way back to the beginning of the universe, it's reasonable to say that everything that's happened from the Big Bang up until now is a chain of events resulting from the way things were in our early universe. That specific arrangement of gas and molecules led to the formation of the planets, which led to the creation of life, which led to the evolution of man, which eventually led to you watching this video. This idea is called the Newtonian clockwork universe, and it's what Einstein meant in his famous words, "God does not play dice." From a completely Newtonian point of view, we have every reason to believe that we live in a predetermined universe. That what you had for breakfast this morning was already decided billions of years ago in the arrangements of molecules. But if that's true, then why do we have such a hard time predicting the future? We know all of the equations that describe the behavior of the largest planets to the tiniest atoms. So why don't we know if it will rain a week from now? Well, let me tell you a story about an American meteorologist named Edward Lorenz. One day, he was using an early desktop computer to model weather patterns. After running a simulation, he wanted to repeat it, so he put the same numbers into the computer. But to his surprise, the outcome was totally different. Why? In the first simulation, Lorenz had entered his numbers to 6 decimal places, but in the repeat, the computer rounded it off to just 3. Lorenz had expected that a difference as small as 0.000127 wouldn't have much impact, but it did. It changed the weather pattern in a totally unrecognizable and unpredictable way. This is commonly known as the butterfly effect. The idea that a butterfly flapping its wings can cause a tornado on the other side of the world. It's important to note that the wind from the butterfly isn't what causes the tornado, but billions of tiny interactions in between that may not have occurred if it weren't for that first flap. This kind of behavior is seen everywhere in nature, from the weather, to the motion of galaxies, how animal populations grow and decline, and the beating of our hearts. So we can see that even tiny inaccuracies lead to huge changes in even pretty simple systems. The unexpected relationship between determinism and predictability is called chaos theory, and it highlights how perfectly logical steps can lead to seemingly random behavior that isn't really random at all. So does this mean the universe isn't determined? Well, no. If we played it back and started in the same conditions, it would play out the same every time. It just means that, in practice, we would never be able to measure anything to 100% precision. So the final outcome of even simple systems remains a mystery to us. Okay, so we can't predict things because it's physically impossible to get all the information. But what if it weren't? What if, in the future, a supercomputer was built that could know the exact position and state of motion of all the atoms in the universe to 100% precision? You have this computer and you find out some people you know are going to a movie tomorrow night. You're not really in with this group, so aren't sure if you'll be invited. You ask the computer, "Will Dana and her friends invite me to the movies tomorrow?" It measures all the particles in the universe, including the neurons in Dana's brain, and says yes. But you get a bit overexcited and start acting weird, which ends with Dana not inviting you to the movies. But if the computer had said no, you would have been a bit disappointed but gotten over it and gone off to do your own thing. This cool attitude would have led to Dana inviting you to the movies after all. So the supercomputer can't give you an answer without changing your behavior. Basically, because it's interacting with the universe, it has an impact on it. So it can make correct predictions, it just can't tell you about them without changing them. So what does this mean for free will? If the unfolding of the universe is predetermined all the way back from the Big Bang, does that mean we have no say in our fate and all the actions and thoughts we're going to have already been decided by gas clouds and molecules billions of years ago? Einstein thought so. After all, the brain is also made of atoms following the same laws of physics. But others believe that we do have free will, thanks to quantum physics. Uncertainty and randomness seem built into the behavior of quantum particles. The quantum world is very different to our daily world, and the equations that govern pool balls and planets are totally useless there. But as with the mad scientist and roulette machine, does this randomness really equal free will? Others think, sure, it may save us from a deterministic universe, but the fact that we have no control over this randomness means we have just as little control over our actions and choices. But legendary theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking holds a different view. That free will is saved not by quantum mechanics, but by chaos theory. If the laws of physics really do govern all our actions, they do so in a way that's impossible to calculate, especially for an organism as complex as a human. That what gives us free will is our inability to predict what we'll do next. So the choices we make are, to us, real choices. Which of these points of view do you subscribe to? You're free to agree or disagree with any of them in the comments below. Or are you?